Oh, jeez. What a sleep. Oh, hi there. Didn't see ya. Oh, nothing like sleeping on a plane. Beautiful. Looking real nice. Oh, yeah. Now, you probably wouldn't know it yet, but life can move pretty quick. One day you're in elementary school, and well, the next, you're on a private jet on the way to your vacation home out in Maui. Now, some would say I'm living the American dream. Thank you. Peanut butter and jelly without the crust. My favorite. What a sandwich. Now, during my fourth grade year, I learned many things. One of the most important things I learned was the value of friendship and how important it is to have good people around you. Something I didn't know a whole lot about at the time was bullying, and how sometimes you can be the bully without even knowing it. See, I'm Andy. I thought I had it all figured out, but the truth was, I didn't. There was still a lot for me to learn. See, life's all about taking one step at a time. And see, this story you're about to watch, was my second step on how I became the person that I am today.
To the district championship, the biggest game of the year. My name is Dean Strawberry, here joined with Al Gator.
Thanks, Dean. It comes down to the two teams facing off head to head. One will walk away with a big shiny trophy. Today we have the underdogs up against the title holders from last year with their star player, the Bone Crusher.
It should be interesting, Al. We have Roseanne Michaels courtside with the one and only Principal Krubs. Roseanne?
Well, Dean, with the intensity rising, you can feel the stadium shake. Principal Krubs, what is your approach going in the final stretch of the championship?
Well, it's all about patience. These boys and girls, they've been working very hard this year. I'm very proud to be here on the court today. I'm also very proud to be facing up against this team today. So we're excited.
Confident words from a confident coach. Back to you, Dean.
All right, let's let the game begin.
All right, guys, this is a key point in the game. Susan, protect the right flank. Alex, you're going to attack straight up the middle. Stay strong and hold your ground. And remember, on the toes, not the heels. Olaf, supply the troops with water.
And don't forget to secure the defense on the left side.
We're sending in the fast bowler. And remember, guys, this is for the district championship. Explorers on three.
One, two, three, explore!
Mustn't register on an emotional level. First, distract target. Fake left. Discombobulate. Counter with crossover right. Headshot. Employ center deflection. Attack pawn. In summary, we gain the upper hand.
What a flip!
flamethrower.
Oh, that's gotta hurt. Two players remain. I don't know how they're gonna get out of this one, Al.
Oh, how the tables have turned.
Unbelievable, they save a toss from a McCaffrey over to Walker for the win.
The crowd is going wild. This is one for the history books.
Still super pumped from the game yesterday, man. It was crazy.
I know, right? I still can't believe it's real.
I know.
Guys, great game. You did amazing.
Thanks.
Hey, we appreciate it. Thank you. Dude, you know what this means now?
That our family is having pizza on Friday?
Well, yeah, that too. But dude, it's like we're famous now, man. We're gonna be like Jeremy and his friends.
Why would you want to be like him?
Well, dude, because Jeremy's rich, man. He gets the new iPads literally every Christmas. That'd be awesome.
So?
Check out my locker, man. Look at all these balloons, man. This is sweet. I got presents, got a card. The heck, I even got some chocolates. Some truffles, dude. It's pretty sweet. What'd you get? You didn't get anything?
Yeah, I guess not.
What the heck?
Andy, way to win the game for the school. If it wasn't for you, we probably would have lost.
Thanks, man. Dylan, why don't we go grab some lunch, man? Maybe share some of these chocolates on the way?
Sounds good.
Okay, let's do it. So yeah, there's the premium milk truffle chocolates. We have four, two each. What do you think?
Did you see Ninja stream on YouTube last night?
Yeah, it was crazy.
All you guys ever talk about is video games.
Well, yeah, because they're awesome.
Did you guys hear it? Jeremy is having his birthday party at the Pet District on Friday.
Isn't he the kid that started the food fight?
Did someone just say food fight?
No. We were just talking. I swear.
You better be right.
No, it was the other kid who started the food fight. I heard it was the best party last year. I'm just hoping we all get invited.
I mean, we could. We just won the big game. We're champions now.
Why do you guys even want to go? I heard he was kind of a mean kid.
I think it'd be cool to go. I heard kids that went all got iPads.
They did? I mean, who does that?
If he's mean, then why go?
Olaf, what do you think?
See, even Olaf wants to go.
I don't know what makes him a bad kid. I haven't heard anything about him.
He cuts in lines and kids are okay with it. He talks over the teachers and his parents won't do anything about it. He even sends mean messages.
Why hasn't he gotten in trouble for any of it then?
I don't know why, I just feel like I'm the only one that sees it.
I think it'd be a good idea to at least tell someone.
Yeah, maybe you want to go see Mr. Krubs about it, just at least so he knows.
Yeah, I'll do that then.
Cheers.
Well, I really appreciate you coming in and sharing this info with me, Dylan.
I just feel like I'm the only one that sees it.
I understand. But you know, you can come to me with any of this. I'll make sure to keep both my eyes open.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to recess. Thanks again.
Oh, and way to be a team player yesterday. You did good, and I'm proud of you.
It was really fun.
Well, if it wasn't for your epic save, I don't think we would have won.
I really appreciate it, Mr. Krebs.
Of course. Anytime. You deserve the win. But I've got to get back to work. So, go have some fun.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's what happened yesterday.
Yeah. Hi, guys.
Hey, Jeremy.
Thanks for winning that game yesterday.
Yeah, no problem.
I just wanted to come over here and invite you guys to my birthday party on Friday.
Seriously? You're inviting us?
Sure, why not? It's going to be a great time.
This is great. Thanks so much, Jeremy.
It's no trouble at all.
Is everyone getting iPads?
Actually, this year everyone's getting Nintendos.
No way!
Dylan, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah.
Guys, I can't believe you
guys. I know, right?
So you got a good group of friends over there. You can keep a secret, right?
Yeah.
So I saw you walk out of Mr. Krebs' office. I know you've been talking to Mr. Krebs about me.
No, I didn't do anything.
You know, Dylan, I'm not a bad kid. Sometimes I just want to have fun and make some jokes. I mean, no harm. And it hurts me that you didn't come to me first to talk about the problem. So, you're not invited to my party. And if you tell any of your friends, then they're not invited either. It's on you if they can't come. We don't want any trouble here. Like I said, I'm not a bad kid. Thanks for understanding.
Dude, I'm so excited for this party. I just can't stop thinking about it. Are you as excited as I am?
I'm actually not able to go.
What? Dude, you have to go, man. They're now serving ice cream at the Putt District, too.
My family has some stuff going on, and it's also the same night as pizza, too.
Well, dude, I'm sure your parents would understand, man.
No, it's fine, really. We can do pizza another time.
Are you sure, man? I just really want you to go to this party.
Yeah, I'm sure. It sounds like a great party. It will be great for you to go.
Okay, man. Well, if you're not able to go, I'll try to get you something. And if not, you can share whatever I get for a gift.
Now, it was weird to be in a situation like this, with one of your best friends hurting. Now, I knew something was wrong, but he didn't know how to tell me. So days went by, and Jeremy and I, well, we became good friends. I mean, he seemed to be a pretty good guy. Started at the birthday party. He invited me over to his house the next night. We played Fortnite all night, ate pizza, heck, we even watched YouTube. But I was a kid, and so something I didn't realize is that I was just forgetting about my other friends. The friends that really cared about me.
It feels so different not having any success anymore.
Yeah, I wonder what's going to happen to the team. Dodgeball would be way different without him.
It doesn't even matter.
It does matter. He was our team leader, and he made that game-winning throw at the end.
Yeah, Dylan, maybe you should go and talk to him.
Guys, let's just face it. He's not our friend anymore. I'm going to recess.
it's his problem. Why do you want to hang out with him anyway?
Dylan? Dylan's cool, man.
He's lame. I invited him to my party and he didn't even show up. That's not someone I'd call a friend.
Well, I'm sure he didn't mean it. I know he had stuff with his family that same weekend, so maybe that was it?
Well, he should have at least told me. He didn't even say why.
Yeah, it's kind of unlike Dylan. I mean, if you want, I could go talk to him about it.
No, you don't need to do that. I was planning on talking to him about it anyways.
You have us now. You don't need him.
Yeah, we've had a lot of fun hanging out with you. You're cool.
And you're the best dodgeball player in the city. You're going pro one day.
Well, thanks, guys. I'm going to go to the library and return my book, okay? I'll see you guys a little bit later on.
That sounds good. We'll see what Lee says.
We'll see ya.
Hey, Dylan. What's up, man?
Not much.
How have you been?
Why does it even matter to you? You don't even care.
Why would you say something like that, man? Like, of course I care.
Really? When was the last time we hung out?
Dude, just because we haven't hung out doesn't mean we're not friends.
Friends? We haven't been friends since you went to Jeremy's birthday party. All you ever do is just hang out with him.
Well, dude, you could have went to his party too. You just chose not to go.
You honestly think I didn't want to go? He told me I was uninvited. If I told anyone in our friend group, you would have been uninvited too.
Why didn't you say something to me, man? Of course I wouldn't have said anything.
What was I supposed to say? We aren't friends anymore.
Fine, man. Whatever.
Gosh. Woo! This story is getting a little serious. I remember that day like it happened in the last scene. In all honesty, bullying is a very serious topic, and it's very hard to talk about most of the time. It happens in so many different ways every single day. Heck, it can happen on a cell phone nowadays, in the classroom, playground, or it can even happen on an emotional level like you see in this story. See, Dylan, my friend Dylan, he was bullied, and none of us knew it. I had no idea that Jeremy bullied him. He was put in a box because of one sentence that Jeremy said to him. And then he felt like he had nowhere to go. You know, even though that moment in the last scene happened, even though at the time I really didn't understand it, looking back, I'm happy Dylan told me how he truly felt.
Hey, Andy.
Hey, guys. I was wanting to talk to you. I just ran into Dylan in the hallway, and he was telling me that you didn't invite him to your party a couple weeks ago.
I knew we couldn't keep a secret.
Did you really do that?
What was I supposed to do? He told the principal on me. Now it's fair.
That doesn't matter, man. You excluded him from your party. Everyone else was able to go. How would you feel?
I'm not a bad kid. Sometimes I just like having fun and making some jokes here and there.
I can't believe you, man. Like, Dylan's one of my best friends.
What are you gonna do, cry about it?
You know what, man? You may not see it now, but you hurt my friend, dude. And that's not cool. How does that make you cool?
Well then, we'll settle this on the court.
All right, everybody, line up. Today in gym class, we're going to play dodgeball. So now, if you have any pent-up frustration, some stress, maybe some friendship issues, now's the time to get rid of it. Put it all on the line. All right, we're going to have the same teams as we had yesterday. So I have to remind you that we throw balls, not shoes. Jordan, okay, Andy, Dylan, since you guys won the tournament last time, I thought about splitting you guys up. Nah, what the heck, I'll keep you guys on the same team. I cracked myself up.
All right, guys, I'm not even worried. They're not even that good. They just got lucky winning that game.
I'm sorry, guys, for not being a good friend to you. I can ask Mr. Wright if you want, if you don't want me to be on your team. I can sit on the sideline.
We know we couldn't win without you, though.
That's not true. I know I got the last kid out and made the game-winning throw, but really it was Dylan who saved the ball and gave us even a chance to win. Dylan's the hero here. Dylan, you're the leader.
Are you guys gonna play today or what?
Olaf, you play for me, okay?
Andy, we need you in the game. We all make mistakes, but you're still our friend. We forgive you.
All right, guys, let's do this.
Well. Look what we have here. Batman and Robin. What a blockbuster ending.
Ha! What a joker.
So, how are we gonna settle this?
Anything you guys want to say? I'll wait.
It's my fault. Dylan, I'm sorry I hurt you. Andy, I'm sorry I got you in the middle of everything. It wasn't fair of me to do that to you.
Jeremy, I appreciate your honesty. But as you know, there will be consequences for your actions. Dylan, Andy, anything you'd like to say to Jeremy?
I never felt so alone. It hurt me not talking to my best friend. And I was afraid you were gonna do something to me. And please don't do this to anyone else. I forgive you.
Thanks for sharing, Dylan. Andy?
Jeremy, I believe you are a good person, but you made a bad decision. And it's a decision that I'll never forget. You know, people do make mistakes. And like Dylan, I forgive you. I want you to know that I'm still here as a friend. And thank you for telling the truth. It means a lot to me.
All right then. Take this as an opportunity to learn. Not a single person in this room, including me, is perfect, but it's a choice that we have to make each and every day to be the best version that we can be. For your friends, your family, as you can see, your actions do affect other people, even when it starts as a joke. Now, I know you boys are only fourth graders, but that's never an excuse to hurt someone.
I'll never forget those words that Principal Krubb said that day. So what happened to the rest of the school year? Well, a few weeks later, Dylan and I became best friends once again. We were playing video games, watching YouTube videos, and well, sharing a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And as far as Jeremy's concerned, well, we welcomed him to the good old dodgeball team. He became a part of the family. And for the rest of that school year, we focused on building a friendship that would last forever. So the topic of bullying is a very important topic. It's more than just a bad word or not getting invited to a party. It's important to understand yourself and that bullying stems from a lack of self-awareness about who you are. You are the only one that can take a step back and reflect on your actions and the things you do say. Sometimes bullying will come in the form of peer pressure of those around you. So make sure you're surrounding yourself with good, wholesome people. Sometimes you may be cracking a joke, or maybe you're excluding people on accident. Just realize that sometimes this can hurt people. And so the goal of the second step is to be aware, to simply be aware of who you are with both the people that surround you and what you do and what you say.
Aloha, ladies and gentlemen. Please stow away your tables and your snacks and entertainment and fasten your seatbelts as we begin our descent into the beautiful city of Maui.
Perfect timing. Aloha, my friends. Just about to land. And just remember, spread those wings and soar like an eagle in the sky. We'll see you around, my friends.
Up from the ground.